Hello students, in this video I am going to discuss about current program status register CPSR of ARM processor. Current program status register is used to monitor and control the internal operation of ARM core. It is a 32-bit register. The bits are from 0 to 31. This 32-bit register is divided into 4 fields. Each field is 8 bits wide. The 4 fields are flag field, status field, extension field and control field. Here the status and extension field are reserved for the future use. Now only flag field and control fields are available for the user. The control field are from 0 to 7. It is having processor mode. Processor modes are 5 bits from 0 to 4. The 5th bit is to select the state of the processor. The 6th and 7th bits are interrupt mask. There are 2 interrupt and interrupt fast interrupt. Next, in MSP side we have flags. All the flags are condition flags. In some of the processor, there is a bit called JBit. It is available only on the JASL enabled processor. This is used to execute 8-bit instructions. So we'll see about control field. Control field, I told control field. In control field, we have processor modes from 0 to 4 bits. Then state bit we have. Next, mask. Interrupt mask bits we have. Processor modes. There are actually 7 modes, 7 processor modes. Each processor mode can be privileged or non-privileged. Privileged mode means it allows the read-write access to the CPSR register. Means all the instructions can read and write from the CPSR register. In non-privileged mode, it allows only read access to the control field of the CPSR and read-write access to the condition field of the CPSR. Means the instructions can only read data from control field, but it can read and write data to and from the condition field. Out of these 7 processor mode, the 6 modes are privileged mode and one is non-privileged mode. The 6 privileged modes are abort, fast interrupt request, supervisor mode, system mode and undefined mode. The non-privileged mode is called user mode. Now, when the processor will go to that particular mode, we'll see here. The processor enters into the abort mode when there is a failed attempt to access the memory. So, whenever it is failing to access some particular memory, processor will enter into abort mode. Next, fast interrupt request and interrupt request. These two are two interrupt levels available on the ARM processor. Next, supervisor mode. When the processor is turned on, initially it will be in supervisor mode, or otherwise we can say when the processor is being resetted, it will be in supervisor mode. And also the operating system kernel operates in supervisor mode only. Next is system mode. It's a special version of user mode and it allows full read write access to the CPSR. Next, undefined mode. Processor enters into the undefined mode when it is accessing an instruction which is undefined or which is not supported by the particular processor. User mode. Last one is user mode. This is a non-privileged mode. It is available for the programs and applications. Next, we'll see about band register. This is the complete ARM register set. There are 37 registers. Out of these, the 20 registers, all these shaded registers are hidden registers. These hidden registers are called banked register. We have seen there are 7 modes. For each mode, there is a set of banked register. Abort mode is having 3 banked register. Undefined mode is having 3 banked register. Supervisor mode is having 3 banked register. Request, interrupt request is also having 3. Fast interrupt request is having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8 and except system mode, all other modes are having set of bank register. Because system register and user system mode and user mode both are having same set of registers. Whenever the processor is changing mode from one mode to next mode, that particular mode in registers will be replaced with the previous mode. For example, if we say now the processor is in user mode, processor is in user mode, it is switching from user mode to abort mode. In abort mode, there are three bank register. All these three bank register, R13 or 14, will be replaced with user mode R13 and R14 register, and this CPSR will be replaced with SPSR register. Another example is given here. The processor is in user mode. Now the user mode is changed to interrupt request mode. In interrupt request mode, there are three bank register, R13, R14. R13 will be replaced with the user mode R13 register. R14 will be replaced with the R14 user mode register. Next, we'll see what will be replaced with the CPSR. CPSR, it is an important register. This also should be stored somewhere. So whenever processor is changing the mode, the previous CPSR value will be stored in SPSR of the bank register. Here the mode is fast interrupt request mode. In the interrupt request mode, the SPSR is SPSR_IRQ. The previous mode is user mode. In user mode, CPSR value will be copied into SPSR of interrupt request mode. So whenever the mode is going back to the user mode, this SPSR special instruction is used to restore the value of CPSR from this SPSR. Now here we can see, now the question is how to change the mode. So in CPSR, the first 5 bits are for mode bits from 0 to 4. There are 6 plus 1. There are totally 7 modes. We have bit pattern, binary bit pattern for each mode. Abort mode, fast interrupt request, supervisor, system, undefined, user. The first 6 are privileged. The last one is non-privileged. We'll see if it is 10, if the binary bits from 0 to 4 is 10111, then abort mode will be selected. If it is 10011, the supervisor mode will be selected. Like that, whichever mode we want to process, we want to choose, we have to write these bits in the mode field.